Incoming! Break, break, break! Sorry. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is BestInSlot and we are back playing a little bit more of the Prehistoric Kingdom pre-alpha tech demo. Now, this is the precise demo we played the other day. Nothing has updated, etc., etc. But we're going to do some things we didn't quite do last time. We just kind of built little exhibits for all of our dinosaurs. And what I want to do today is build, like, a big safari zone. Those of you who've watched my Jurassic Park Operation Genesis will know we have a tradition every year when we do the series, or every half year this year, where we build a big safari zone that you drive your jeep through and you see all the dinosaurs interacting and stuff like that. And I thought, this game, we can do pretty much the same thing. We've got big fences, we've got lots of dinosaurs, and we have a jeep. What more do you need? Nothing, ladies and gentlemen. You need nothing. So, let's build. I think we need metal. It needs to be a big, tough exhibit, you know? Come on, game. I know. I'm asking a lot from you, especially for a bloody pre-alpha demo. But you can do it, babe. You can do it. Let you drive down by the beach. And then maybe we just connect back up. There. So you could go either way. Oh, bloody... Where, oh. Where have I gone? Over here? Yeah, there we go. All right. Can I actually change path width? No, not yet. Okay. Did I miss a bit? Oh, no, I thought I did, but I didn't. Okay, so we've got a little path for our car to follow as it goes along. Maybe we need a little bit of something over here. I don't think I can add water yet, can I? That would be nice, but I don't think it's possible. No, not yet. But let's just do a little bit of what we were doing before. Just do it over here. Stereos that need a little love. You still want to get like a plains kind of feel in some bits, but some... Oh my god. The game is struggling ever so slightly. Like really dense forest right in the middle here. Like completely surrounded by plains. Or the dinosaurs come on about. Just spice it up a little bit. We also need some rocks. Rocks. Everyone needs rocks. Rocks are the best. I'm going to put some lampposts over here. I wish it had stopped zooming in. Okay, cool. Right then. I really wish this was the other way around. I completely messed it up. Rocks. Rocks is what I'm looking for. Bigger rocks. Not too big, but just spaced around here and there. Just. I don't know. Make it a little bit more interesting to look at. This isn't the best. I'm gonna like they could do with being a slightly better method of doing this. It's not that intuitive. Like if you could just edit the size here, that'd be nice. Rather than having to click it and then edit it on a rock and then having to reduce it further, kind of thing. Am I making sense? I know what I mean. I love rocks. Right, okay, that will do. I think I'm pretty happy with that. Okay, so only thing left to do is actually get some dinosaurs in here. Now, we do want to work this out. Like, we want a lot more Gallimimuses than we want, say, Tyrannosaurus Rexes. You know, we want to balance it out. We want more Gallimimuses than actually anything else. So let's get two more of those. Try to mix it up a little bit. But in terms of the coloration, if you think about it, or at least as far as I'm concerned, there probably wouldn't be that much difference in coloration in, like, a herd. Because they've been coloured to adapt to a certain environment, sort of thing. Okay, let's get some youngers. And they can be different coloured, because it doesn't really matter. And let's get some little bebes. Bebes! Okay, see what I mean? Lots of Gallimimuses. And once these are all done, we can select all and place selected. And place all of them together. Now, if I was a guy mouse, I'd probably live, probably up here in the top. Probably more like around here, right? This is going to be Gallimimus town. Can I rotate? Yep, there we go. All All the babies together in the middle. There we go. Gallimimus is done, having a grand old time. Next up, let's move on. Velociraptor. Up. Up. There we go. A little bit more individual, less of this pack mentality. We're going to get one of each colour. Stick them all together. Just one dude. Need a dude. I don't think they can make babies anyway, so I don't think it actually matters, but just for my own entertainment, really. Maybe just sum that a little bit smaller. Maybe it's like a little pack of dude raptors roaming about, like a street gang of velociraptors. You know, that's a thing. And then the women, just a little bit younger, different colour. Doesn't actually matter. Two of those. This is these two best friends writing in their diaries and such or something. And some babies. There's maybe too many raptors in retrospect. Oh well, I've committed now. But we'll move these away from the Gallimimuses. Which are... I mean, I assume everything's kind of going to spread out anyway. And they're going to be more like in the forests, I think. So let's put them... I want to spread them out, actually, a little bit. Like, the older ones are down here. The kids are hanging around down there in the corner. Right! Tyrannosaurus. I only want two T-Rexes, I think. We're going to have a scaly one. No, we're going to have two feathered ones. We're going to have a mama and a papa and a bebe. Boop! And... female. I really like the ginger one. Ginger and black beard. That classic combination. And a bebe. Maybe not a bebe. Maybe like a... it's juvenile, like that. And he's scaly right now. No, if anything... the baby would be more feathery than the adults, so we can't do that. Because he'd be covered in down and such. And these dudes live by the coast, because Jurassic Park 3 was wrong. It needs, like, brachiosauruses and stuff, I think, you know, to really come alive. Triceratops, where are you, beautiful? I really like that one. Let's get a few of those. Yeah, according to... I'm gonna call him Nedry, but he's obviously not called Nedry. What the hell is his name? Kirby! Mr. Kirby! The Triceratopses. Let's get one. The black sheep of the Triceratopses. According to Mr. Kirby, he knows that the big dinosaurs... oh, these were all women. Okay, that's fine. The big dinosaurs would not want to be by the coast. For reasons. I don't really know what his reasoning ever was, frankly, but whatever. I'm sure he had. Now, there is one problem, in that it's bloody nighttime and you can't see a bloody thing. So what we'll do is we'll skip forward, folks, and as soon as day breaks, we'll go on our first little tour. I'll keep adding some dinosaurs in as well, just more Gallimimuses and stuff, kind of spice it up. It's a beautiful new day. I've added a few more dinosaurs to the exhibit. Not too many, because I have a history of maybe putting too many in, but it's a beautiful sunrise. There was a little storm a second ago. It was raining, and it's kind of stopped instantly as soon as I tried to show it to you guys. But anyways, let's hop into a Jeep. There is one problem. The path is very difficult to see. Let's hop into a Jeep, and away we go. Can I zoom in? Yeah, but I don't want to. Zoom out. Let's go. Turn this off. Boop. Little adventure, there we go, the first dinosaurs we see, a little Triceratops over there as well. Little juvenile Tyrannosaurus Rex. What happens if I run it over? I'm kind of curious. I have to find out. My god, it's made out of metal! Okay, screw the path, let's go! It's a little bit laggy. Ooh, sorry. Careful. How you doing, guys? So, living out your natural lives. I want to go see the T-Rexes down by the coast. So, the Gallimimuses, a lot of them should be around here. The forest isn't as dense as I thought it was going to be. I really thought I'd gone overboard, if anything, but it's not that bad. Is that a T-Rex? Incoming! Break! Sorry. Okay, I want a nice... oh my god, my car's actually breaking. Look at it. Absolutely dented. Hello. Okay, the car does kind of move on its own. Okay, lovely. I'm sorry. I'm just trying to get next to you, okay? Oh, wrong. Bloody Nora, I need to learn my left and right hand arm, I swear. What happens if we drive into the water? We'll try that in a second as well. I know. I'm sorry. Forward. Where's your lover and child? That's what I've been looking for. Is there actually a human inside there? No, it's a magical car. Ah, lovely. How you doing? You doing good? You look lovely. You're just kind of chilling here. Where are your... Yeah, like, where's the rest of your family? Lead me to them. I will follow you, okay? You know what? No, I'm going to go try this out. What's the worst that could happen? Woo! Well. I'm kind of impressed they accounted for that, to be honest. I really didn't... I thought that might just be fine. I thought maybe I'd, like, drive along the bottom of the water or something, you know? I'm a little bit impressed right now. Right, where is the other T-Rex? Oh, I forgot that you can pause. Just have a little wander around, shall we? Our safari zone. Dinosaurs just living out their lives. Well said, buddy. Well said. Now be careful, there's a T-Rex down there. Oh, he's so feathery though, I love it. That's good. Oh, we got one of the little T-Rexes. A little scaly one. Oh no, you're not scaly. Stay still. You are definitely feathery. You're kind of terrifying. Kind of looks like just a very old man. Look at this forest. That's awesome. There's no one live here. Someone can live in the forest. It'll look pretty. And really, what else matters? Absolutely not a bloody thing. I do have like 13 FPS. The game is clearly struggling to handle quite so much stuff. You know? No, it's not my PC. See, again, thunderstorm. I swear. Hello. What is that? Is that meant to be the moon? It's terrifying. It's like straight out of Destiny. Hello, you're not full adult, are you? You're a little bit tiny. You're like a little sub-adult, I guess. Dum-dum-dum. It's maybe the closest I've been to... Oh, no, that's the closest I've been. Inside the Triceratops. It's probably the closest. Let's go take a look over here. There's a lot of dinosaurs hanging out over here. Mama Triceratops and a little baby Triceratops, all sub-adult, chilling together. I really like the Triceratops. Look at it, it's beautiful. And you're so cute. I want to get you two together. You could totally do like a little documentary with these guys. Little guy Maris over here, not doing much. What's that noise? Oh, little raptor. We've not actually seen the raptors yet. There we go. First time. Stop making that noise. Is it you? Ugh! Raptor, calm down. Hello. You are one who knows how to hide in a bush. I appreciate that, son. I appreciate that. You're a good lad. Where's your friends? Why have you all split up? Do you not have a pack mentality at all? I guess not. Ooh. Did that Gallimamus just light up as a Christmas tree for anyone else? Moderately confusing. I don't know, it's a fun little world to play around in, you know? More than anything else, it's nice to explore it. People have been dumb in the comments in the last video, no offense, but like, oh, this isn't as good as JPOG, blah blah blah. It's a pre-alpha demo, guys, come on! I think if this game fulfills the potential, all they really have to do, add more buildings, have a decent campaign mode, have lots more dinosaurs, this will be the best dinosaur builder ever made. One of the best park builders ever made, one of the best games ever made, in my opinion. It, honestly, it has that much potential. All the basic framework is amazing, and it's so much fun just to do this, you know, fly around and check in on your dinosaurs. It'll be better, obviously, when there's more interactive AI between the dinosaurs. You know, you want to see the gallimimuses flocking together. You want to see the triceratopses getting or fighting with the T-Rexes, and the T-Rexes hunting down the gallimimuses, or the raptors packing up to jump on the triceratops. No, maybe not that, but you want to see a little bit more interaction between the dinosaurs, sure. But, I mean, the actual framework of the game is awesome. Why do you keep glimmering like a bloody Christmas tree? I think it's because of the fences. You know, like these are very science-y dinosaur fences, and I think it bugs them out a little bit, but it's strange. I love it. It's really cool. The baby T-Rexes look worried though, don't they? He looks like he's just seeing something he definitely shouldn't have seen, you know? That is a scarred T-Rex right there. Not a happy man. Not a happy man. Or woman, I have honestly no idea. And just little dinosaurs pockmarked around. Never did find the other big Rex. I put down two large T-Rexes down over here. That's the one from before, I think. Oh, someone's in the water. Oh, that's a car. Actually, this isn't the one from before, is it? You're terrifying. Have I ever told you that? You also look a little worried as well. There's something about the eyes that's a little bit off on all of them. I think the eyes need a little work, because look at that. That's horrifying. But from a distance, you're very pretty. The water's nice as well. Can I go in the water? As low as it goes. Looks okay. My Jeep! My poor... Wait. What? Oh, it's okay. You're right, love. It's actually flooded inside the Jeep. I like that. I mean, that's just because the water just kind of cuts in through the whole thing. But still, it looks like it's just flooded inside, which is pretty cool. And this is weird. This jumps down over here. I guess as it gets deeper into the water. Hopefully one day as well, we'll get some stuff out here. So I imagine we'll be able to have like a Mosasaurus exhibit right here in the middle of the ocean. That'd be so cool. Anyways, okay, so we're not going to come back and do any more of this demo just because we have definitely done everything I could possibly want to do with it as it stands. But there we go, nice big safari zone, loads of dinosaurs. I really wanted to play it again. And yeah, obviously when the game itself comes out, we're going to be straight back on it. No hesitation. And, you know, it will be a full series if the game comes out, blah, blah, blah. And also, I imagine it's going to be early access because every game on the planet's early access. So we'll do what we do with Saurian, wherein basically whenever it updates, bam, we are there. We are playing it day one. Thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. Do hit that like button if you enjoyed this video. And I shall see you lovely folks in the next episode. Cheers. Much love. As always. Bye-bye.